The scars of protesters' fury wiped clean, waiting for progress. This is Ferguson, 1 year after white police officer Darren Wilson shot and killed unarmed black teenager Michael Brown, unleashing months of protest. Though Wilson was not indicted by a grand jury and he was cleared of civil rights violations by the federal government, Brown's life became a symbol for something more, that black lives are too often treated as dispensable in American society.
Regardless of if you saw what happened or not, it was the blatant disrespect that people feel because they left his body here for 4.5 hours. And so that is really what charges people up.
Filmmaker and Ferguson resident Chris Phillips lives in the apartment complex where Brown was killed. So moved by the raw emotions he witnessed, he began recording it, culminating in a documentary.
Has anything changed in the relationship between police and people here, especially in this particular area?
I don't think anything has changed with the relationship because they're still not engaging their citizens.
After a Department of Justice investigation that found Ferguson was disproportionately and excessively ticketing and fining its black citizens to bankroll its budget, the white police chief, city manager, and chief judge, all criticized in that report, have been replaced. The new interim police chief is black, so is the new city manager and the new municipal judge, as are two new city council members.
What's left to protest?
So really, it's kind of like you can use the analogy of weeds in a garden. And for some people, it's just kind of like you can pull all these weeds out, but if you still have one there, then, you know, the weeds can grow back again.
To some protesters, the mayor is that weed that must be removed. They see the interim titles as a temporary smokescreen with no real change in how citizens are treated. But Ferguson resident Blake Ashby disagrees.
We are moving forward. Our city is getting better. That will not happen overnight. You know, destruction is immediate, and for the people destroying, very gratifying. Change is hard and takes time.
Though Ashby says he is not blind to racial disparities in America.
Statistically, it's hard to say that our society values African-American lives as much as white lives. Hey, hey!
Ho, ho! He isn't the only one who worries that a small sliver of the new movement could tear the racial divide open even further.
Essentially, what they're doing is they're dismissing the efforts of everybody else who doesn't do things exactly the way they do. If we're not out shouting at the cops and threatening to rape their families, then somehow we are not really committed to the cause of social justice.
Back on Canfield Drive, a plaque serves as a reminder of what happened here, trying to make a point that this wasn't just about Brown's death, but the rebirth of a civil rights movement.
With this legacy, I think it has affected the world in a good sense because of the fact that it did make people motivated to speak up, to march, to rally, to fight for change.